Hey friends, have you ever listened to a drum loop and wondered why it sounds so good and so interesting? In this video, I'm going to show you how you can extract the juice, meaning the timing, the tone, and the volume changes from any drum loop, so you can not only learn from it, but flip it and make it your own. This video is really going to come in handy for folks who use sample sites like Splice, as recently using sounds from those sites might get your music flagged for copyright issues. This video will help you protect yourself, but more importantly, it'll teach you something that will help you sound original and be more creative. So to prove to you how awesome this workflow is, I'm going to go ahead and show you an A-B example of kind of the result first. I took a UK garage loop from Splice, and then I flipped it using my own samples and turned it into my own. Check it out. Okay, so I've got these two drum loops that I've downloaded from Splice. And these are UK garage style loops, and the reason I chose this specific genre is because it's very swung, and there's a lot of dynamics in there. Like, there's quiet and loud drum hits to give you that kind of like push and pull kind of feel. Take a listen to this first loop, right? And then here is a percussion loop that goes with it, and together they sound like, right? So what we're going to do is we're going to extract the juice. we're going to flip these samples, but still preserve the UK garage kind of signature sound, okay? All right, so let's start with this first loop. Now, you'll notice that a lot of loops that you download off the internet kind of repeat themselves. Let's take a listen. Now, if that's not exactly identical, it's very close to being identical. So there's a fair amount of prep work with this workflow. So something that's nice to do is to simply just delete what you don't need, okay? And just focus on one rep of the drums, okay? So I'm gonna just do that. Now, the next thing that you need to do is that just because I've taken this loop and made it half its normal length doesn't mean that Ableton is going to recognize it as such. If I double click on it, notice that I still have two full repeats, right? So what I need to do is actually click on the top of this audio, Command or Control J, which consolidates it. Now you'll notice that Ableton, I can't zoom out anymore, right? Ableton has recognized this as a totally different waveform. And now what I can do is I can right click on the top bar and I can choose Slice to New MIDI Track. So Ableton has a really awesome inbuilt transient detector, just like the transient detector that's in each clip. We can use this to our advantage. So if I go ahead and click OK, what's gonna happen is Ableton is gonna spit out a drum rack. Now you can see that there's a drum rack here and it's got a bunch of these slices, right? I'm gonna go ahead and undo that and let's look at it one more time. So right click on the title bar, slice to new MIDI track, create one slice per transient. And what it's gonna do is it's gonna tell you how many slices it's gonna make. So it's gonna make 14 slices, okay? You can choose other things. Like you can choose, for example, to slice this up by timing divisions, right? But we're not gonna do that. We're just gonna use the transient because this is what's so important about this workflow. So hit okay. Let's go ahead and listen to the sliced result. So I'm soloing that. So what's going on here is that there's a slice for each one of my drum hits. Right? And Ableton has them in order. And you'll also notice that they're not snapped to the grid. Just like the clip is not snapped to the grid, the drums themselves are not snapped to the grid. And this is a good thing, okay? What we're trying to do is we're trying to extract what makes this drum beat tick, what makes it work, right? We're trying to learn from this. So zooming back out, the next thing that we need to do is we need to go into the piano roll. Now, the next thing I can do is I can limit the amount of samples that I need to flip. So let's go ahead and do that. So let's take a listen to this drum loop. Slice 6 and slice 2 are the exact same sound, right? So I don't necessarily need to have slice 6, so I can move it back to slice 2, right? And something that can help me is if I turn on my headphones, right? So now if I click on any of these, right? That's the same sample. That's the same sample, right? Now that's a different sample, right? All three of these are different samples, but these. So that's unique. Let's bring this one back down to the kick. So now I notice that slice 5 through slice 9, I don't even need to worry about those, right? So I could maybe even just delete them. Okay, so here are all my slices that really matter. So now let's listen to this. Okay, so in order for this whole thing to work, we actually need to also consolidate each one of these slices. Right now, Ableton thinks of these slices as one loop. See, if I can zoom out, I can look at all of these different hits together. We don't want that, right? Instead, we want Ableton to think of this as a sample, this as a sample, this as a sample, and so on. So the way that we do that is we right-click and we choose Crop Sample, okay? So I'll go, and then you'll notice I can't zoom out, right? So we can do the same thing with the second slice, crop, crop, crop. It'd be awesome if there was a way to just do this really quick. Unfortunately, there is not, to my knowledge. So I'm just making all of these samples discrete. Okay. Once you've done that much, this is where the fun part starts, okay? So if you have a big sample collection, you can click this button here. And this will switch the drum rack's mode to similar sound mode. Now, what's so cool about this is that with one click of a button, I can now ask Ableton to listen to this slice and then provide me with a similar sound to that. So here's the original loop. And remember, it's very loud, okay? Something that might be nice to do here is to grab yourself a utility before we do this and maybe crank it up a little bit. And let's also maybe grab a glue compressor and put the little soft clipping thing on it just so that we don't clip out. And now we can listen to our slices. Maybe just a little bit more. Okay, so now they're a similar volume. So now we can go back here and start listening to some of the similar samples that Ableton is gonna find for me. So I just clicked it to the right once. Let's take a listen to this. So I really like this combo right here, right? But I don't like this kick drum. So something else I can do is just simply click on any of the left and right controls just for the kick. Love that kick right there. That's awesome. Now these two samples are exactly the same. This system is not perfect, but I can keep switching through to try to find different ones. Love it. Now let's listen to these last samples. Maybe I'll just loop it from here. I'm not sure about this percussion sound here. Love it. Sounds awesome. So essentially, I've extracted the tone and the timing from this original loop. Let's take a listen to the first loop. And in my opinion, I kind of like my samples better than the samples that were originally used to make this loop, right? So real quick, if you're enjoying this video and you're curious about the music that I make, I recently put out an EP called Bug Features, which is actually a benefit for something that I'm really passionate about. Insects like pollinators and other invertebrates are declining between 1 and 2% per year. So my chosen response was to create a native wildflower campaign. Habitat loss is one of the main drivers of this global issue. But if you replace part or all of your lawn with native wildflowers, you provide a crucial habitat for our insect friends. Unlike many things happening in the world right now, this is a problem you can actually do something about. So how this benefit works is if you buy my EP on Bandcamp for this week only for $5, I'll triple your money via a $20 gift certificate to Prairie Moon, a North American native wildflower supplier. I'm gonna buy people seeds until I go broke. So if you don't live in North America or you don't have lawn space, you can still support me via streaming the new album or checking out my Ableton courses. Okay, let's get back to it. Okay, now let's go ahead and listen to this with the hi-hat loop. Now this works, but this hi-hat loop is not mine, right? So let's do the same thing. Let's do it a little bit faster. So I'm gonna go ahead and I think I might just repeat this first little section. kind of like that. So again, I'm going to consolidate this, right? You can also right-click and just choose consolidate, but it's Command or Control J, and let's go ahead and get rid of the rest of these. And what I'll do is I'll just right-click, and I will choose slice to new MIDI track. I'm going to use the transient feature. It's going to make 9 slices. And just for simplicity and speed's sake, let's just go ahead and leave this as it is. And I'm going to go ahead and consolidate each one of these hits. Okay, so clicking on the slice, right-clicking, and choosing crop sample. Let's get a utility, slap it on the end there, maybe turn it up a little bit just to volume match. And now let's go ahead and try some similar samples. So turning on my similar sample swap button, I'm gonna click to the right. Let's take a listen. Cool, let's go ahead and take a listen with my original beat. Nice, love it. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and drag my beat down here. Maybe duplicate it. Not really sure about this sample. Nice. Now, I want to show you something else. So I have copied yet again the tone and the timing from these hats, right? From these hats right here to these hats right here. Something else I can do is this. I can right click on this and I can choose to extract the grooves. Okay, so what this is going to do is it's going to extract the timing and the velocity from these hats. And then it's going to make a new groove right here. So now what I can choose to do is I can choose in this clip right here, I can choose to apply a groove. Now check this out, I'll choose my percussion loop here. And if I were to leave this the way that it is, my global groove amount is set to 100. Now what this is gonna do is it's going to change the timing, okay, of this loop. I don't want that. I actually, what I would rather have is it to change the velocity, okay? I'll pull this up a little bit. What I can do is I can actually commit this groove. Now check this out. Now you'll notice that there's some velocity changes in the drums. Now something else I wanna do is I also want to duplicate this one over top of this one. So that's what we're going to do here. That way I can have my velocity on each one of these. You'll notice that in Ableton's preset that it creates whenever you slice up a drum loop or any loop is you're presented with this system where you can turn up the velocity. Listening to this now, the samples are sort of flat in terms of their volume across the slices, but I can turn up velocity and take a listen. Now we've extracted that push and pull kind of feel from this original loop. And we kind of, let's zoom in a little bit and really take a look here. You can see that this sample was quiet, right? But if I look at this drum loop, you'll notice that that sample is now quiet just like that one is, okay? So now we've got more of the feel of this beat, the volume differences kind of copied, right? Now we can do the same thing with this drum loop if we want. Remember, we're going to need to turn up velocity, but the first thing we can do is go up to this beat and we can say, okay, we're going to extract the groove. Now you can see that we've created a third groove here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to choose for this loop right here, I'm going to choose this third groove that I've created, right? I'm going to turn the timing down because if the timing is up, take a listen. It's a jumbled mess, right? We don't want the timing. We just want the velocity changes, okay? Now, I can go ahead and commit these velocity changes, and you'll see that it's not that much of a difference, right? But these last little samples here, those need to get quieter, right? So I'm going to go back into here. So I'm going to go back into the drum rack, and I'm going to turn my velocity up. Let's take a listen now. Right? It got quieter at the end. Without the velocity, take a listen to the end. So I don't know if a full velocity needs to happen, maybe something more like 30%. Right? Great. So now that we've got all this done, let's go ahead and group these together, and we're gonna listen to the original, okay? This is the original up here, and then this is my newly extracted drum loop. Oops, I need to duplicate this real quick. Okay. I really like that stick click sound. That's kind of fun. Awesome. So just like that, I'm now a UK garage artist, right? Well, at least in as much as I've learned something, I now know what makes a UK garage loop tick. I know that there is a lot of swing. I know that there is a lot of volume changes that create the feel of that genre. Now, admittedly, I sort of baited this video, right, with the idea of getting around like content detection, right? Getting around copyright flagging and stuff like that. But what I'm way more interested in is creativity and learning, right? So this is a really awesome workflow that you can use to actually not only, of course, avoid those filters, but to be creative and to create new things and to try new things, right? And to learn from pre-existing loops that you really enjoy. So I hope that you learned something here. I hope that you enjoy this. If you like this kind of thing, like, comment, subscribe. Much love, everybody. See you next time.